Yes, welcome to the last talk of the night. I'm actually happy. I'm sad to leave the place here, but it's also pretty cold. So I'm also looking forward to have a beer after this. But first, I have the opportunity to talk to you guys.
I got my beer here.
You got your beer. Yeah, you're smart. Too. I'm always done. But and we're going to do this in English because we have an international guest.
Yeah.
Welcome, Sadek. Am I saying it right? Like this?
Yeah, Sadek.
And you're part of the ST4, is your
is the
name
ST4, the project, or the artist.
And I'm so happy because I'm Tunisian as well, so yes. I was happy to find a Tunisian
I'm
friend.
I'm happy because I'm doing an interview with Tunisia.
So. Oh my God. But so good that you're here.
And, thank you.
Can you explain something about what is ST4? How do you explain it normally?
ST4 is a duo artist, basically, and we work together at the same thing, and we do the same style together. We like paint together, we sketch together, and we like discuss the concept and everything. And then we have this one name shared by two people.
Yeah. And did you go to school together, to art school together or something?
We met in the high school when he was young, when he was 16. And then because he was part of the ultra groups of the stadium, like football ultra groups. And then one day, because we're from Sfax also, like it's a city in the south and there's no like big culture there. And one day we find each other like doing graffiti, and Yassine was doing graffiti, and I found this like, oh nice, it's the first time that I see someone doing graffiti in this village, in this like city. And
wait,
then
how did you, by accident you saw?
Yeah,
you
exactly, saw, yeah,
oh,
by
really?
Accident. And then
because I think it's not allowed there as well, right? Like in Holland.
No, there is no law about it. You know, we're missing laws.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
it's
okay, yeah,
nice for this. So yeah, we did a coffee and then we start like meeting every day, and then we are studying at the same school also, and then we went to the capital together.
That's so cool.
Yeah, and
that
then
you found each other.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
Good
and
coincidence.
Yeah, and were you also, do you have the same style or do you, is it different?
We are super different. We're like ultra different from each other.
That's also good.
Yeah, and this is like creating a balance in creating and thinking, because it's not easy, you know, to work in duo, because you're not a collective or like more duo, because we need to have the same result in the end. So we need to find the balance between two different ideas.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, and Guido, welcome to the table.
Thank you.
You're also part of a duo, but you're here now at the exhibition for your with your own art, right?
Yeah, I'm not part of a duo. Well, I am with my brother actually, but not an official duo, but I'm part of the High on Type collective.
Exactly.
We're five friends who love type and letters and calligraphy. But here in the show, I also have a work on my own, my own name, my own work. So, yeah.
And is it in the same theme with letters or calligraphy?
Yeah. What I mostly do is using the brush by hand, writing with ink. And most of the time, let's say 99% of the time, there is letters as an outcome. Yeah.
Wow. And yeah. How did the passion start for the letters?
I think graffiti, yeah, mostly. Like me and my brothers, we were doing graffiti since we were 10 years old, which was actually quite early.
Well,
don't
you're
ask me why.
Like
it was just like being in the car on the highway and then just seeing all the graffiti and then rewriting it, redrawing it, and just being fascinated by it was enough.
And it's also exciting, right? If you're young, it's something you can't really do, I guess.
Yeah, it's there's a certain tension, I think. There's a certain rebellion, which is of course very nice if you're in that age. Especially when you're like let's say 14, 15, and it's really nice to have something to kick to. The love for letters really came from. But of course, later on, it got like, being related with calligraphy and starting to be interested in graphic design, doing our own graphic design on a very young age, just for fun, you know, not for clients or something, but just for fun. And all of those things really helped sparking and the love for letters and keeping that really alive, and
And you found four more people that love it the same way as you do.
Yeah, I think so. I think the collective started because of that, finding new friends, finding with the same interest. And I think what also really helped forming the collective was to find a very specific interest in letters. So not only letters as a whole, but let's say just a very specific way of doing it, making the calligraphy and starting to look for the boundaries and going over these kind of boundaries. So not, calligraphy can be a really boring thing.
It takes a long time.
But also when you think about graffiti, you don't think about like very flashy, cool stuff. You think about your aunt doing it on a Wednesday evening with the like the hobby crew or a hobby group. And calligraphy for us is really like finding a freedom in writing and finding new forms. So then we started the High on Type, and then at first it was more like organizing workshops, and then from workshops we went to festivals, and from festivals it was like, okay, what shall we do next? Making books, doing exhibitions, and
nice,
yeah,
really cool,
move by move.
Actually, when I looked at your work, I also thought I saw some type of lettering, right? Is that
It's lettering.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
It's
based, I wasn't
on,
sure. Yeah,
it's based.
I was like, I was so scared to ask dumb questions. Like,
no, yeah, exactly. This is the purpose, like, from doing this work. Like, I mean, this work is based on Arabic letters, Arabic typography, a bit of calligraphy, but also local Tunisian architecture, like vernacular architecture or popular. And this like a mix between a lot of backgrounds that we have in our country, because, you know, when we was doing graffiti, we tried to do like, you know, old styles of graffiti, like wild style and everything in Arabic. But then we wanted to develop it more to like doing something it's unusual.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying, still trying, but then we stuck in this style, and then we find out that it's interesting because it's more abstract. It's like more about shape, more about like colors, more about composing and taking details from your culture that no one take in consideration. Then we mix.
Yeah.
So yeah. Like.
And how is it to be an artist right now in Tunisia?
It's a hard thing to do.
Right?
Yeah.
I mean, I know the whole country has problems now with even finding work. Or
It's. I think in Tunisia, it's not about the country.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about like government and system. There is like upcoming scene now. It's super interesting. Like our generation that we grew up with revolution. And there is this artist now, like super interesting, like scene is coming in the next years. And we are like, we're thinking more about like being more open to the universe, you see, like, because we're like internet generation.
Exactly.
And
yeah,
we know all these artists here from internet, from Instagram, from like, I don't know, from all these platforms, and all our friends and the community is like now working hard to like be in that level of being international, you see.
And you can show yourself online.
Exactly, yeah.
And
it's easy.
So is that, I saw you guys were pretty active on Instagram and on social media. Did you need it for your to show yourself?
Yeah, sure, yeah, sure. Like, it's the most important, I think. We don't like it, but...
I know, yeah.
Because we don't think about it that much. Like, we...
But aren't you also traveling a lot because of, like, being present online?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Right, yeah. And we like it in this part, but we don't like it when we need to think about it, you see? Like,
I know
when
what you,
mean. You... I don't know, like, you need to do stories. And when it became, like, a program... You need to do this,
like,
you need to do that, and you feel like, oh no.
I always make the comparison with doing your homework when you were in high school.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you have to do
you
it.
You have to do it.
But you don't like it.
But you also feel kind of dirty, right? When you're
on it. Like,
yeah,
it's like, oh shit. I put it in my agenda every day. Like, okay, 30 minutes, I do it. And then it's...
Enough.
Shut
enough.
Up.
Enough. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. This is what we do.
But how did Linda and Bruce, how did they find you guys?
We asked them, and then they said that they wanted artists out from Europe and US, because I think the lineup is mostly from Europe and US. So they searched all around, and there is also Mina, she's from Tokyo. So they searched like all around the continents. They find out like the festival that you worked in Morocco 2019. And then they told us like they find something interesting. I don't know, like, and then.
And is this scene in Northern Africa way different than here?
Yeah, sure.
And what is the biggest difference?
I don't know.
You don't know.
The tricky question.
But it's but it's maybe it's less present than here.
Yeah. It's different in terms of like organization, in terms of like what kind of artist, what kind of like interest. Like, for example, the street art scene is not as big as, for example, in Rotterdam, for example. Like, and there is no street art festivals in Tunisia, for example. There is only one, like, ruled by a Tunisian-French guy that he did, like, great festival in Tunisia. And it's, like, it happened in 2014, but that's, like, there is few more, like, small, you see, like, there is no this interaction and giving, bringing this from this country and making artists, like, meeting this one, and it's, like, there's this kind of exchange that can change your way of thinking.
Exactly.
So, I don't know, but there is other things, like, more contemporary, more, like, conceptual, more, like, there is other things are happening, and as I told you, it's, like, upcoming scene now, it's crazy.
That's good.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, happy about it.
Hey, and how's the scene here, by the way? Is it organized? Or is it different types of clubs?
Well, I don't know, because with the word scene, then still it can be a lot of different scenes, you know. So if it's, if you ask me about
there's no graphic
type or typography or letters scene, then I know a little bit about it. And then for graffiti, I don't know a lot about it anymore because I'm not really active as that, as a graffiti writer. But art, yeah, is also like too huge to even. So I think the answer to the question is just like, yeah, there's a shitload of stuff happening. Yeah.
No, but I was.
We're spoiled actually with stuff like this, being on and doing an interview on a radio station about what we do.
I don't even know where you're from, by the way.
Oh, it's Utrecht.
Utrecht, yeah, okay.
Yeah, it's all that close here. Yeah. It's just the Netherlands.
Yeah, it is
just
so close. Yeah. But and I always look at Utrecht as a more, how do you say, netjes? How do you say it?
Yeah, it is.
More,
yeah, it's very much just a university city.
Yeah. Not really rebellious.
No. And compared to Rotterdam, you can definitely say that. Yeah. But I'm just very happy with my studio there and with my friends being there. So, yeah. And when I want to go to Amsterdam or Rotterdam, then I'm there in 30 minutes, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah. Or 40.
Have you seen Rotterdam a little bit? Or?
Yeah, sure. We was partying yesterday.
So.
But this is not Rotterdam, man. This is Schiedam.
Oh, yeah, this is Schiedam.
No, we was in Rotterdam.
I'm so happy you said that. I'm in my own.
You'll forget it, right?
Yeah. I feel really bad now. I hope the director of the museum is not listening to this interview.
This is really a Schiedam thing.
It's really Schiedam, of course. But I actually really like Schiedam, and you have really good parties here
so
as well.
Nice.
Warehouse parties. Secret warehouse parties. So I love Schiedam. Let's just thank you for saying that because I was but never mind part of them, huh? Where is Schiedam?
Okay.
So you're not going to a party
anymore. I was stuck in Schiedam now.
Hey, and okay.
You're talking about situation here in the Netherlands, being everything being closed on Mondays, right?
Yeah.
Let's talk about that.
What did you say? I missed
they,
it.
They arrived on the Monday,
yeah?
And everything is closed on Monday in the Netherlands.
Yeah, the timeline is weird for us. Like, I've never seen something closed on Monday.
Yeah.
It's like,
it's
a nice thing. I think I love seeing things closed on Monday because I think people that are active in the weekend, then it's like, okay.
Yeah.
Day rest.
Yeah.
Enough.
Bye
Monday.
Bye.
Yeah, there's nothing you can do, man. Not even in the cities,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
No. But you've been here since Monday. And when do you leave?
I'm leaving tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
We're leaving tomorrow, Paris. And yeah.
What are you doing in Paris?
Well, we traveled by Paris, you know, because it's hard to get visa from other countries. Easiest for us to, like, have visa from France.
Yeah.
So
I thought you had like this big something going on, but you're just
a little bit. Yeah, we have something.
You can't say
it's not active now. We have our gallery there, but
oh, nice.
Yeah.
But so, but you just told me before we started that you finished your school in 2018.
Yeah, 2018. Yeah.
And already in 19, you had your first exhibition.
Yeah, our first solo exhibition in 2019.
How is it possible? What did you do so well that you already had an exhibition at after 1 year?
Thank you for the compliment. I don't know, but yeah, we really love working. Like, this is something that we believe in. Like, just we are like full-time artists. We don't do anything else. And when we finished the studies, it was like, there is this gallerist that she likes our work. And then she said like, okay, we can like just start now, like do your first solo. We was afraid, to be honest, because, you know, we just start doing canvases, even like it was our first time even to do canvases, because we're used to do walls. That's what we know. Like, this is the only thing that we know how to do, you see?
Yeah.
And then there is this small white thing you need to paint on. This for us is like a lot of limit.
Yeah.
And then boof, everything like changed, because you need to think another time about like your work, how it needs to be in a canvas or in a small thing or in a sculpture, or like, then it's like another challenge. It was super good, the exhibition. It was successful. We were shocked, to be honest. And
you get some confidence already.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly. Yeah. After the exhibition, it was like, oh, nice. And then we traveled for the first time after it to Paris. We did like a mural in Paris. And then it was something interesting, because you see other artists, you like pieces like...
Oh. I'm so sorry. I thought he was waving. Yeah. Because it was only 5 minutes left.
Yeah. So yeah, short story. It's
You can notice it's my last talk.
Yeah.
I'm not as sharp anymore.
You're waiting for your next beer.
No. I'm really enjoying this. I guess you're really happy, right? If you're doing what you love.
And, yeah, sure. So exciting. Like, a lot of challenges, a lot of like things that you don't know. So you're like learning every day. You're meeting an artist that he does something, and
what do you like? What do you like more, like doing the canvases or the walls?
Tricky. I think both. Now it's became like both.
Yeah,
sometimes it's nice to get out from the street and enter to the studio, going from 9 to 6.
Well, just the working. Is always smaller.
Yeah, but now it became big also, because a lot of details.
So you like the wall better?
Yeah. I mostly make, almost every time I need to make, or I'm asked for an exhibition or something, then I just ask like, okay, how much space is there? Can I write on the wall? Is it okay? Because, you know, if I make something in my studio, then it has to fit through the door.
Yeah, sure.
That's the biggest size. Yeah, you know.
The big challenge.
Yeah.
Do you know where your love from this type of work comes from?
Well, actually, I like to relate to the surroundings. So I think I'm also interested in making art for a specific moment and a specific space. Whether making art on a movable object like a canvas or whatever, it's just art for you never know.
Yeah, is it and okay if it's temporary? If you put so many hours of work in it?
Yeah, I actually really love the fact that a lot of my works aren't there anymore. Maybe it sounds maybe a bit strange, and a lot of times when a museum or somebody you work for has to like paint it white again or the color of the wall again,
I thought it would hurt.
Yeah, but it doesn't hurt. For me, it's like perfect, because then I'm not dragging this luggage with me through life. It's also a little bit philosophical. Like, you can leave a footprint on the earth, but you can also just don't do it, and then
it makes you free. It sets you free, I guess.
And I have the picture, and I had the moment. Like when I feel sad, or sad is maybe a big word, but when I was done on Thursday? Yeah, no, Thursday afternoon. Then I really felt sad, because I built up a bond with my work. I was in the middle of it for 2 days in a row, really intensely building up, and then all of a sudden it's finished, and then I grabbed the chair. Maybe I don't know if you saw the moment.
I
grabbed the chair and I was just sitting inside of the work, like, oh, yeah, okay, I don't want it to end.
But it's not always a love relationship, right? It's also sometimes you can hate it sometimes,
yeah,
as well,
okay,
right?
But this time it was really like, okay, this is my moment with my work now. And also, I think because of the work is also on the floor. So then there was this three-dimensional effect where I could be in the thing instead of just looking at it. So, yeah. And then I was a little bit sad. But if they're going to paint it any other color, I don't know how they would do it because it's directly on the brick wall. But then I'm just okay.
Maybe a practical question. How do you work? Do you just make it in your studio and then how does it work?
I measure the whole thing, and then in my studio I do the calculation and the thinking, and then
it's not a free work, of course.
No, it's really about calculating, and I have to calculate the brush size and the white space in between the strokes. So yeah, it's the freedom is in the moment. Yeah. So when I calculate everything, that's really like that isn't so free, let's say, but the moment itself, when the brush is on the wall, then it's freedom, because then I could do a lot of things, but I just do whatever I like. So yeah, that's the freedom of writing, I think. Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Hey, what else is coming up for you guys? Some big projects, or do you have some time off right now?
I'm doing actually very big work, like 5,000 square meters on the floor on a square.
Where?
And in Utrecht, in a suburb for a elementary school on the square, the playground. And it's going to be in stones, so...
Is it interactive for the kids as well? Or?
Yeah. I actually made a whole language with the kids.
Ah, wow.
So it's a...
That's a huge project then.
Yeah, it is. So it's going to be 2022 or 23 even. But it was super nice. Like, my work is about letters. And this time we made up a new language to speak to... life outside of Earth.
Sounds
with the
very,
kids.
Very
yeah,
cool.
So,
the kids will be off to high school already when you finish. Everybody's like, what is this language? No, I'm sorry.
I'm thinking of making actually a little publication about the process so that all the other people also could understand it.
Sorry, that's really mean.
No. I actually had the same thought.
Oh, yeah.
Because the kids where I was working with, they were probably leaving school.
Already smoking joints and everything.
Yeah.
I'm kidding. Okay, hey, and what about you? What are you? Are you a big project you're working on?
I don't know. Like, we prefer do not talk about projects when they are not finished. Like, so
that's very smart.
Smart. Like, because sometimes
it doesn't work.
Like 2020. You see, we had a lot of projects. Then it's like nothing happened. Yeah. Only like street walls, but. So
we learned from COVID. How is that one project going? And you're
it's not working. Sorry. we don't like giving promises.
I can maybe tell one thing about the project we're gonna do in the Glashart exhibition.
Yeah, for sure.
So it's not there yet, but it is gonna happen.
we
painted all the walls, and with my collective with High on Type, we're gonna do this crazy project of playing. It's actually designed the playground for us, for ourselves, but also for students who will come by, and we're actually gonna play with leaving marks. So it's like playing, writing experiments, and anything can happen. So it's really gonna be fun in November, first 3 weeks. It's gonna be all play.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Nice.
Sounds really good. can you tell me something about your work that we can see over here? Is it too broad of a question?
No, like, we literally don't even give names for the canvases.
Untitled one.
Untitled one, exactly. This is it. Like, we really love composing and like playing with the shapes. So we did these paintings this year in January in Paris when we was there, and then we was about like we bring them from Paris to here, and then we choose the colors from these canvases, and then we experimented something like new in the wall, like new composition, new like kind of colors, so from the canvases. We don't have too much to talk about the work. Like, it's there is no.
Okay, but I can make it up to you. So people just have to come here and yeah, see it exactly. And enjoy it.
Yeah, exactly.
I saved you.
Interact with it.
Hey, I think because when he waved at me, it wasn't a wave. It was 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, it wasn't. Hey, thank you so much.
Thank you
for being here.
Thank you.
I had a lot of fun. And
yeah. Likewise.
I'm going to say something in Dutch.
Yeah, say it.
Nou, jongens, welkom voor de... Welkom, ik ben helemaal in de war, joh.
I don't understand.
No, you I said something welcome. Wrong. No, dankjewel voor het luisteren. Glas Hart is nog tot 16 januari hier te bewonderen in Schiedam. Dus kom vooral langs. Het was een heel, heel leuke avond om in ieder geval met de artiesten te praten. Dus de werken zijn zelfs nog mooier, denk ik. Ik weet echt niet meer wat ik zeg. Ik moet echt zo snel mogelijk de microfoon wegleggen. Maar hartstikke bedankt voor het luisteren. En tot de volgende keer. En ja, tot snel hopelijk.
Dankjewel.
Bye.
Dankjewel.